So we're really talking about the low-hanging fruit here, as Mangesh mentioned, the getting people on the board, the cultural change. What do you recommend, Jean-Marc, in terms of where to start? Is this should you look for the quick hits, the quick payoff projects first?
Good question. I just want to say one thing on the back of what Mangesh said. I think the litmus test, one of the litmus tests for kind of validating that we are on the right path with data mesh implementation is how quickly a data user, like a data scientist, can go from a hypothesis of, I think I can do something with this data and find patterns, to finding the data and peer-to-peer consuming that data, understanding it, be able to use it, be able to make, sense of it, and use it in, in ML, and be able to kind of publish those models into production and rinse and repeat and iterate over it. So I think that's a really good litmus test for us, no matter where we are in that journey, to see, are we reducing that gap between the consumer and producer? Back to your question, Paul, as where to get started, I think both Richard and Mangesh had really good points around, let's get started with actual use cases, the business cases where the data generates value. Let's identify a few of those key use cases and use them as a driver back to and work backward to find out, okay, which are the data sets or data domains that we need to unlock. And as we do that, let's build the platform iteratively that enables this peer-to-peer communication between the data providers and data producers, not necessarily building integrations into the application databases, but building what is needed for them to share analytical data at scale and kind of rinse and repeat that. And as we go doing that, I mean, a lot of organizations that I work with also started with tech because they thought they needed tech, enabler and uplift to enable the domains, but very quickly realizing that, in fact, we need to have those domains engaged early on. So if you're getting data from, I don't know, the claims department or from the clinical report, clinical visits people, the people who manage those applications, let's have those people involved early on and bring them on the journey, because it's very hard to kind of push that to them and not have them engaged early on. So I always say, let's just start with value, use cases, business drivers, work backward to identifying those domains and incrementally enable those domain data products, and incrementally and iteratively build the platform that gives autonomy to those kind of domain technical teams. I mean, at the end of the day, data mesh tries to align with the business in a way that we have aligned technology with the business. Like, we in the early 2000s or 2000, actually 2010, probably, we started kind of really structuring our technology to align with the business, right? We had microservices team or application teams that are dedicated with product owners that understand a particular aspect of the business. What we're trying to do is extending that to data. Why data is this foreign thing that we have to give to other people? So let's extend and empower them so that those teams can use data, can share data, the same way we build technology aligned with the business domains.